Okay, we are going to be making the train and building some train parts today. I'm going to start off with some simple ones and then we'll work our way to more complex ones. So we're going to start with the hitch magnet and then hitch peg, and then we'll move to the stack, linkage peg, and then the body. So we'll kind of work our way through. I'm using the images that have notes on adjustments that need to be made, and we're going to pretty much follow those adjustments for right now and work our way through those. One thing I want to note is that every hole that's on the parts that we create, we're going to use the hole feature to do that. So for example, this hitch magnet, we're not going to just draw two circles and extrude. We're actually going to draw one circle, extrude, and then create a hole and drill a hole through the part. So just be mindful of that. There's a reason for that, which we'll talk more about later when we do the whole feature and when we make sketches of each of these parts. But for right now, just know that that's how I'm going to create all of these. So this is going to be a 0.450 for this diameter. I'm going to go into Fusion. I've got my file set up. I need to create my components. So my component one is going to be my hitch magnet. And then I'm going to go ahead and create a circle. So using my C hotkey, D hotkey, 0.45 inches on that. And then I'm going to extrude and need to go back and just take a look at that. So it's a quarter inch tall. Again, using some hotkeys, E for extrusion on that. I'm going to do a hole on this top surface and move it to the center point of that, and this is going to be a 0.25 inch hole, and it's going to go all the way through. So distance, I can just say all and just say okay, and now it's cut all the way through. There is my hitch magnet. So there's our first part. Let's do a new component. We're going to turn this one off so we don't see it. This is going to be my hitch peg. Whenever it gives you a drawing with a view like this, a section view, typically I'm going to draw a profile of that section view and then revolve it. So there's a couple of notes that it says here. So coincident with center axis is the point. So we've got a couple things here because of some diameters, so we'll have to turn those to radii when we use them. But I'm just going to draw the general profile. Again, it's 0.65 tall, so it's not too tall. So again, I'm using my line tool. So that looks good. Again, I'm just roughing out the shape at this point. I'm going to now create some dimensions. It's 0.65. This from here to here was 0.4. And I think that was a diameter, so I'm gonna have to change that. This is 0.25 diameter, so I'm gonna divide by 2. Put this divided by 2. And then I think it, what else did it give me for dimension? 0.5 up to this point there. So this right here should be 0.5. And then it has an arc from here to here. So I'm going to use my three-point arc tool. Select this top corner, this corner, and do an arc. And now that automatically did, I don't want to do that because I'm going to dimension this 2.208, I think is what it says in here. Yeah. Now, if it was supposed to be tangent to that, it probably is. But I'm just going to stick with the 0.208. Coincident with center axis. That looks probably fine. This all looks good. This is coincident to that axis, which looks right. I can't move it, so that looks good. I'm going to go ahead and finish that sketch and then do my revolve and then select the axis. Say okay. And there's my hitch peg. New component. Let's go to our drawings and let's see what's next. Let's do our stack. So again, we're gonna make the entire thing and then we'll revolve and then we'll drill a hole. This is a counterbore hole. It gives us some dimensions on our counterbore here that we're gonna be utilizing. So let's do that. So we'll use our line tool. Again, just roughing out what this is gonna look like. Again, just kind of checking with that. So it gives us a 0.5 inch diameter for the bottom. Kind of start down here and work my way up. This is going to be 0.25 for the radius. Start with this dimension here. It's 0.25. And let's see what else. 1.5 up to here and 1.75 to the top. So 1.75 to the top, and from here to here, it's 1.5. It gives me an angle measurement for this guy. It's 15 degrees this way, so if I made this, let's say 60, you can see that that now gets closer. So if you think about it, if this is 15 degrees, this is a 90 right here, so what would this be? It would be 75 to make that 90. So there we are. I think it tells us the dimension here is 1.25 inches for a diameter. So it's gonna be 1.25 divided by 2. And there's our stack. So everything is fully the way it should be. We're gonna revolve on this axis here. Say okay. And then we want to create a counterbore hole on the top. So we're going to use my hole tool on the top, move that to the center, use a counterbore. I believe that this one is 0.875. Check that. It's 0.875, that's 0.375 deep. This is 0.375 diameter, that's 1.5 inches deep. So 0.875, depth of 0.375, and then we have a 0.375 that is 1.5. You kind of see that in that space. That looks good. And we'll click on OK. And there's our stack. Again, if you want to, you can always you can always right-click and go to opacity and do like a 50%, and that allows you to see that interior detail you've cut away if you need to see it. So it's handy to do that if you want to see the inside. Next component. Let's see what's next. So we've done all of these. We'll do the body later. That's a little bit trickier. Cowcatcher's tricky. Let's do these two because this is pretty straightforward and this is very similar to what we've already created. So let's do this one. This one has quite a few changes to it. We're gonna have to make adjustments with. So here we go. It's gonna be the linkage peg. Again, very similar start. This one's going to be 0.125 divided by 2. Actually, I think it's smaller than that. I think it's I think the correction is that's a diameter. So it's 0.625 divided by 2 on this one. So 0.625 divided by 2. This one, I think, is a half inch. And then I think the overall height is like 0.625, maybe? Check that. Oh, 0.25 and 0.325.